the Laplace transform to solve this initial value problem. So I'm going to do from left to right, step by step. On the left side, apply the derivative theorem. I have s squared capital Y of s minus s y of 0 minus y prime of 0 plus for this one, for s capital Y of s minus 4 y of 0 plus 13 capital Y of s equals. So this is a direct delta function, and the Laplace transform of that one is equal to e to the negative s t naught. So whatever t naught is, you just plug it in. In this case, I have e to the negative pi s, okay? Okay, looking at the conditions, I have y prime of 0 equals 0, y prime 0, this is 0, okay? So take a look at the capital Y of s is, and then factor out capital Y of s. I have s squared plus 4s plus 13 equals e to the negative pi s. This one, y of 0 equals 1, so plus s minus 4, okay? Now this one, completing the square of this, I have s plus 2 squared plus 9, right? S squared plus 4s plus 4 plus 9, which is 13. Now divide both sides by this. We have 1 over s plus 2 squared plus 9 e to the negative pi s plus s over s plus 2 squared plus 9. This one, I'm going to write it down. S minus 2. Or s plus 2. Okay? Minus. So minus 6. Over s plus 2 squared plus 9. So y have s plus 2 minus 6 here. Okay, look at this. The denominator is the same, right? So you combine the top together, which gives you s plus 2 minus 6. So 2 minus 6 is negative 4. So s minus negative 4, right? And this is what I already had here. So it doesn't change anything, right? Now take the Laplace transform of this. For this one, work this out first. Alright, and this one, it's gonna be a sine, right? Unless you have 3 on top, right? Because the, for sine, kt, you need to have, it's gonna be equals k, l of this, k over s squared plus k squared, right? So you have k squared, which is 3 squared, and you don't have 3 on top, so you need to multiply by, you need to have the 3 on top. And initially, we don't have 3. So when I put the 3 on top, I need to have a 3 on the bottom. They kind of say, well, actually, what I mean is I multiply this by 3 over 3, right? And I use 3, so I have left 1/3. Right? And this, like I mentioned earlier, is going to be side 3t. But because there you have the unit step function, the t has to match up, which means that it is 3 times t minus pi. Okay? And don't forget to put the parentheses around it. Again. Okay, we're not done yet for this one because we also have a shift here. That means that we need to have e to the negative 2, and again t minus pi, not just ts, not just t itself. Okay? That is for the first one. Second one. So here the fun fact. This become cosine of 3t times e to the negative 2t, right? Because you have the shift here, so it's going to give you e to the negative 2t, and without the shift, you have s over s squared plus 3, that is cosine 3t. So the reason I have s plus, I need to have s plus 2 on top is to match up with what I have on the bottom. Without it, you cannot find the Laplace, the inverse transform of this one. And last one, again, this one, similar to this one over here, you need to have the 3. So you can break this out to 2 times 3, right? And you need 3, so you have 2 e to the negative 2t times psi 3t, okay? So that is your final solution. That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.